Do you have dry, dehydrated, aging skin? Or how about hyperpigmentation and large pores? If you have sensitive, reactive, red, blotchy skin and you've tried vitamin C and you've tried Retin-A or retinol and you ended up getting a rash or blotchy skin, then today we're going to be talking about another anti-aging alternative, and we're going to be talking about the 6 anti-aging benefits of niacinamide. Hi, my name is Christy with Go See Christy Beauty Boutique, located in Southern California, and I have been treating clients with acne, hyperpigmentation, fine lines and wrinkles, and other skin conditions for over 11 years, and we're going to be talking about niacinamide. I actually got a couple requests the past 2.5 weeks about niacinamide. One person in particular heard a lot about it on YouTube, put it on, and she actually got really red, blotchy skin. So we're going to be talking about niacinamide and how you can incorporate that into your skincare if you have rosacea, sensitive skin, or reactive skin. So the first one is niacinamide has multiple benefits. So it is an anti-aging ingredient. It actually improves elasticity. It actually helps reduce hyperpigmentation and redness and blotchiness, sallowness of your skin, which is the yellowing of skin. It also helps with increasing hydration and helping the fine lines and wrinkles. Niacinamide also has shown in clinical trials to be more tolerated by all different types of skin types, unless some people have found it to be reactive when mixed using vitamin C and AHAs, retin-A's and retinols. So also, if you are using any of those products that is leave-on and then you put niacinamide on top of it or it's mixed, you tend to develop redness and rashes if you are more on the sensitive side. If you are using an AHA-based exfoliant or cleanser that's rinsed off, that tends to work better with niacinamide. It also has been shown to shrink the pores. So it is not only better tolerated by most skin types, but if you have oily or combination oily or breakout prone skin with regular use, it actually helps minimize the appearance of large pores. Now, this can also be because it actually increases the skin's ability to hold the water and increases the hydration capability of the skin. So with oily and acne skin types, when you have more hydration, your skin produces less oil. So not only does it increase the hydration capabilities of your skin, it's actually a moisturization booster in moisturizers, and it actually helps speed the epithelialization of the skin and helps the photoprotection of the skin, which can then lead to the improving of the skin's natural barrier. So for example, when you're reducing inflammation or decreasing dehydration of the skin, this actually leads to the overall health of your skin, slowing down the immunoaging of the skin. Now, before we get to the other benefits of niacinamide, if you are finding this information helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet and would like to still continue to learn more about skincare products, the application of products, and their ingredients, then please consider subscribing. And don't forget to hit that notification bell. Okay, on to the next benefit. In clinical studies, when niacinamide was applied directly onto the skin, they showed results in reduction of fine lines and wrinkles, reduction of hyperpigmented spots, yellowing of the skin, and blotchiness of the skin. In a clinical study that was done on 50 Caucasian females aged 40 to 60, and it was a blind test, placebo-controlled, left-right randomized, and split-faced test assessing two tropical products. Topical. Okay. Two topical. I need a little fruit thing on my head. Chiquita banana. Sorry. I'm going cuckoo here. Okay. Assessing two topical products. So one of them was just a moisturizer controlled product versus a moisturizer plus 5% niacinamide in it. And so what they found was in that testing, the people that used the moisturizer that had the 5% niacinamide had significant improvements in their fine lines and wrinkles, in their hyperpigmentation spots, as well as the redness, blotchiness, and sallowness of skin over just the moisturizer control product, so the one not containing the niacinamide. So like I mentioned before, some people have experienced some rashes or skin irritations using the niacinamide, and it's usually because they are mixing or using another product that has L-ascorbic acid, which is vitamin C, or retinol, retin A, or AHAs. And so if you haven't seen the video of anti-aging ingredients you should never mix, then go ahead and click on that above or below to check that out. So if you are thinking about or considering using niacinamide and incorporating that into your skincare, then please hop on over to my blog. We're going to go ahead and include it in the links. To avoid making this video much longer, I'm going to be evaluating some of the niacinamide products according to their ingredients and what I think may be a better fit for your skin type. So all the links, including to the clinical trials or products or any of those, will always be in the description below. And remember that makeup is always an art and skincare is a science.